I have a little boy, y'all, so if I look tired, it's because I am. Yeah, he's the greatest, man. He's he just turned 4, and 3 was a tough year. I don't know if you're parents. Yeah, 3. Yeah. They say the 2s are terrible. My son was great when he was 2, but he had a shitload of rollover minutes. He's been using them. 3 is the new 2, as far as I'm concerned. My son's got it made, man. He doesn't even realize how much he's got it made. First of all, he's got a father who believes in nonviolence. Yeah, but he tests that shit daily. Right? It's amazing how the whole day can turn around. Everybody can be in a great mood, and then that little fucker won't put his shoes on. Yeah. Now there's timeouts and crying and toys in the attic, you know? Doesn't even get it, man, how good life is. He could be riding home from a day of playing at his grandma's, fall asleep in his car seat. He wakes up, it's the next morning, he's in his bed, pajamas are on, Cheerios are on the table, Tigger and Pooh are on deck, you know what I mean? How are you ever unhappy when your pajamas have feet, you know? He doesn't have anywhere. I wish that was my life. I'd just be coming home from work, I'm out, you know what I mean? Wake up the next morning, everything's taken care of. I got one thing I step into, zip, fucking I'm out the door. Everybody telling you how cute you are all day long. So, I don't know. That nonviolence, it's hard to implement with a kid. You know, I know Martin Luther King had kids. How did he do that? How did he do the nonviolence? Like, put your shoes on or we're fucking marching, all right? Grab the picket signs, Coretta. Let's go. I'm telling you. And they're expensive, too, man. People already tell me. He's 4. You need to start saving for his college like 3 years ago, man. That's $25,000 a year minimum. Like, well, then he's going to be home college. Yeah. I don't have that kind of cash. My wife and I just bought our first house, and it was built in the 70s, so it's got a lot of work that needs to be done on. I'm ripping off old wallpaper. I have a list of things to fix on that house that I will never be finished with. What I need the most is a husband, I think. Yeah, someone to build shells and fix the gutters. I just want to be the guy that my wife is fucking around on her husband with. But the house is great. It's for my boy, really. It's got a nice yard. It's in a cul-de-sac. There's only like 4 registered sex offenders in the whole neighborhood. But they're a lot of work kids, man. When I met my wife, she wanted to have 4 or 5 kids. Now we have Odin. She's like, this is it. One day he'll be like, why can't I be a big brother? Like, well, maybe you should have thought of that shit when you were 1. Maybe slept through the night a few more times, kept your hand out of the dishwasher, we told you. Yeah, there's a reason kids are so cute. It's so you won't throw them in a dumpster at 3 in the morning. Yeah, and if you're not laughing, that means you don't have kids, as far as I'm concerned. But I am no longer number 1 to my wife. I realized that. You know, she told me she wanted to get a tattoo with Owen's name in it somewhere, like on her foot or her ankle or her toe or something. Well, I think he's cool, but I've known my wife a long time, and she has no tattoo, so I'm kind of giving her shit. I'm like, baby, that's cool. Get a tattoo. But you know what? There's no Tom tattoo on you anywhere. She goes, yeah, I know, but this is our son. This is permanent. It's like you laughed a little too hard right there. You're like... That's great. We went out and bought a king-size bed last year, which I think is the best investment ever for a couple. But I found out during the shopping process the most important thing to Serena about the bed was that she not be able to feel me move while I was sleeping on my side. And I remember we met 12 years ago. We slept in any bed. We slept in twin beds. We had to be touching it every moment of the night. Wake up in the middle of the night, not touch it. It's like, oh, baby, I miss you. Come here. Just a toe, something. Yeah, 12 years later, she's like, what the fuck? Would you quit breathing on me, please? Oh, my skin crawl, seriously. Yeah, over there with your sweaty ass legs. Let's go. That's all I need is one more human being climbing on me today, if you don't mind. Yeah. You guys know you've been in relationships for a long time. It's weird, man. I love my wife. We've been together a long time. It's just, we have a great relationship, great marriage. Sex is great, but it's not like it is when you first meet. You know what I mean? When you first meet, it's all about the passion. You can't keep your hands off one another. You got to pull over to the Cracker Barrel parking lot on your way home from the movie. Right? Yeah. 12 years later, it's just different. You know? I had a buddy ask me, he goes, Tom, you could have sex with any woman in the world, past or present, who would it be? And I was like, well, that's easy. That's my beautiful wife, Serena, 12 years ago. That's when she was attracted to me. Yes. Not funny? Ha ha ha. Somebody's relationship is...